Hey guys, it's Blackstone. Betty, one thing y'all know I love is tacos hot off the Blackstone. And in this video, we're gonna make the famous Barilla tacos. My apologies now, my list of things that I don't say right just got a whole lot longer. But either way, we're having fun. These are so tasty, you guys are gonna love them. I know it, so let's get right into this recipe. Barilla tacos. If you don't know what they are, where you've been hiding, they're all over the internet, and I figured let's try to throw these down completely off of the Blackstone griddle. Now, barilla is a Mexican stew. It takes a little time, but it's well worth it. We're turning these into a cheesy barilla queso taco with cheese and corn tortillas. They're gonna be delicious. Barilla is traditionally made with goat or lamb meat. However, you'll see them everywhere using beef because, well, beef, as we all know, is readily available to us versus the traditional goat or lamb. Now, I've done my research. I've watched tons of videos. I've been watching everyone making these. I'm taking a little bit of everything, adding my twist, making them fully on the Blackstone. So let's jump into it. When it comes to picking your blend of chilies, everyone is going to pick their own different kinds. I'm going with guajillos, anchos, chili de arbos, which I'm probably botching that word, some chipotles and adobe. Each of these will bring a different layer of flavor to our stew, some heat and some smokiness. I have some black peppercorns, cloves, bay leaves, Mexican oregano, which is a little different than our traditional Italian oregano. It has that earthy, citrusy flavor, unlike Italian, which you can taste often that minty flavor. We have cumin, fresh garlic, a couple plum tomatoes, a little tomato paste, apple cider vinegar, a large white onion that I've sliced in half, and our salt. We're gonna slide that salt aside and hold off on to that for now. So let's start with a small pot of water heating directly on our Blackstone. Now, of course, if you're making this, you can do this on your Blackstone side burner, which would be more efficient and quicker, or do it right in your kitchen. We're gonna be using this water to rehydrate our peppers, our dried chilies. So we first have to remove the stems and all of the seeds inside. If you would like to leave the seeds, go right ahead. They're gonna add more heat to your stew. We'll drop these in and submerge them completely underneath that hot water for about 10 to 15 minutes until they are softened. I'll remove this and set it on my side tray and let it just hang out and do its thing. Now I want a little char on my veggies, so down goes some oil, and I'll add my onions, tomatoes, and my garlic cloves. Move them around, toss them around for about 3 to 5 minutes until charred. Then I'll add the tomato to that still warm water that our peppers are rehydrating in just for a minute or so until we're ready for them. Pull off my onion and garlic. Now we can begin to blend all of these ingredients together, which will make our adobe sauce. Adobe sauce is our rehydrated peppers, the onions, the tomatoes, everything that I've showed you. So into a blender goes as much as I can fit. My peppers, the onions, the garlic, some of our liquid that we rehydrated our peppers in, our tomatoes, tomato paste, just a small amount to add even more richness to this adobe, some of our vinegar, and all of our herbs and seasonings except for the salt. Blend this together until it becomes nice and smooth and set it aside. Now into a larger pot on our Blackstone or Dutch oven, again on the side burner or in your kitchen. We're gonna add some oil to that. To this hot oil, we're gonna add our adobe sauce. We're gonna refry all of those peppers and the onions and the tomatoes, the garlic, everything in there is going to fry in this oil and cook down. While that's hanging out doing its thing, let's talk about our beef. Since we're doing beef barilla tacos, you want to look for a good ratio of meat to fat to bone. The fat adds flavor, of course, and our bone adds a lot of collagen and a deep richness. So I went with beef bone-in shanks, beef short ribs. These are gorgeous and they were on sale, so I picked them up, and a beef chuck roast. This I've cut into large portions. We'll season our beef really well with some kosher salt and black pepper. Drop down some hot oil alongside our adobe sauce and let all of this meat sear. really hot and fast on the outside, turning that golden brown crust all along each side. Our meat looks perfect. Our adobo sauce smells heavenly already. So let's drop in our meat, give it a toss, and then I'm gonna fill my pot until all of my meat mixture is covered in water. To that, we'll add some salt, give it a mix. We're gonna put a lid over this, let it hang out and stew together. The longer the better. Go for at least 2 to 3 hours. If you wanna make this the night before, it's perfect before a party, or make it early in the morning for dinner. But the longer you can let it simmer, the better it's going to taste. You can either let this hang off on your Blackstone or the side burner, or on your stove, or in the oven in a nice Dutch oven. We're looking for our meat to be so tender that it falls off the bone. You'll notice once it's done, this thick layer of oil or grease on the top of your pot. This fat we want to drain off and reserve. Just use a ladle, scoop it off, and set it aside. This is something that we need. We need that fat to fry up our corn tortillas nice and crispy. Now it's time to remove our meat. I'll place it into a throwaway tin, making things easy. Remove all of the bones and give everything a quick shred. This meat just is so tender, it falls right apart. And what we're left with in our large pot is now called our consommé. A consommé is our adobo sauce that's stewed together with our beef broth that came from all of that meat that we had in there cooking, the bones, everything. And now that we have our meat, our consommé, and our fat, it's time to get cooking our tacos. Prep is key. I love the 36-inch Blackstone for making these for a large crowd. They're quick, they're easy, and they are just gorgeous while frying up. I have everything else already ready and prepped. We have our corn tortillas, some Oaxaca cheese. Oaxaca cheese is a white Mexican cheese, kind of like Monterey Jack, but it's stringy like mozzarella and melts just gorgeous in tacos. I, of course, have some cilantro. I've already diced some up. I've diced up a white onion, nice and fine. And I have some limes that will cut into little wedges. So let's get cooking. My Blackstone is hot. I'm gonna drop down 1 or 2 corn tortillas, completely up to you how many you stack. Corn tortillas are a little flimsy and fragile, so if you go 2, you'll have added protection from your taco possibly breaking. Give them a quick dip in that fat down onto the Blackstone griddle. We'll top it with our Oaxaca cheese, some of our meat, some more Oaxaca cheese, because you can never have enough cheese, a ladle of our consommé, and then give these a fold in half. Now you'll let these fry on both sides until each side is nice and crispy and crunchy. Keep it going and make as many as you can for the crowd that you're feeding. Save your leftover meat and grease and consommé in the fridge for a later meal during the week. But once you're ready to serve up, you're gonna serve these alongside a small bowl of consommé, which I love adding extra meat, tossing together our cilantro and onion, adding a little of that to our consommé, a squeeze of lime in there. Pile up my tray with my tacos. I literally could eat 2. I'm kidding, I could eat 5 or 6 or 7 of these. The best part to me, besides watching them griddle how gorgeous they are, is once they pull off nice and hot, pulling them apart till they open, seeing that cheese pull and zhuzhing them up with our cilantro and our onion mixture as if it couldn't get any better. The most fabulous part of this entire recipe is taking every single bite with a scoop of your taco into that consommé. Every bite just gets better and better and better as you go. These are so delicious and I cannot wait to see you guys making them. They're easy, although they take a little time to get things started, but once you have your different elements, your meat, your consommé, your fat for frying, and of course your tortillas and all of your garnishes, things just rock and roll so smoothly on the griddle. I can't wait to see you guys making these. They really are delicious. So go make them, post a picture, tag Blackstone Products, tag Blackstone Betty. I cannot wait to see you guys making these at home.